गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट ओम्स लॉ व्हिच इज ए टॉपिक इन द करंट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। सो नाउ वी शुड डिस्कस अबाउट द स्टेटमेंट और डेफिनेशन ऑफ ओम्स लॉ। सो व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द Ohm's law. Listen here. For a given conductor at a given temperature, the strength of the electrical current through the conductor is directly proportional to potential difference across the conductor or across the conductor. So let V be the potential difference and across the conductor, and I be the current passing through it. According to Ohm's law, I is directly proportional to V. That means if the proportionality is removed, in place of proportionality equal to comes and afterwards 1 by R, I is equal to 1 by R into V. That is the Ohm's law, where R is the electrical resistance of the conductor. If you see this graph, if you plot the graph between current and voltage, taking current on y-axis as well as voltage on x-axis, the voltage is proportional to current. It represents a straight line. This is the straight line. The graph represents a straight line which is passing through the origin. So slope of this straight line is equals to tan theta, that equals to I by V. And we know that I by V is equal to 1 by R. And if you see the second graph, taking voltage on y-axis and current on x-axis, you will get here also a straight line which passes through the origin. So the slope of this straight line is, slope is equals to tan theta, where theta is the angle making with the x-axis, that is equals to V by I. So where V by I is equal to R. So here I by V is equal to 1 by R. Here V by I is equals to R. But this Ohm's law has some limitations. So the Ohm's law is valid only for linear conductor or ohmic conductor. So linear conductor or ohmic conductor means metals. Linear conductor or ohmic conductor means metals. So for some substances, some materials such as semiconductors, vacuum tubes, transistors, amplifiers, so for these Ohm's law does not valid or does not holds good. For metals, this Ohm's law is valid. For the semiconductors, vacuum tubes, transistors, this Ohm's law does not valid. For example, if you replace the resistance wire, if you substitute a torch light in place of resistance wire, what happens, you see, when the voltage is low or when the voltage is small, the current is also small, and here the line is straight line only. When the voltage is increased, the current is also increased because they are proportional. But what happens here is, as I said, according to the Ohm's law, voltage is proportional to current through the conductor. But here what happens is, the current passes through the filament of the bulb. So when the current increases, the filament gets heated. So when the filament gets heated, the temperature of the filament increases. But you must know one point. The temperature affects the resistance. When the temperature is high, the resistance is high. When the temperature is low, the resistance is low. When the temperature is fixed, the resistance is fixed. Here, the temperature is fixed at a constant temperature. But here, since the current is increasing, the filament gets heated. Temperature is high, means resistance increases. According to Ohm's law, when the resistance is increased, current and resistance are inversely proportional. It is increased. If the resistance of the filament is increased, current is decreased. So what happens here is, if you take the graph, if you plot the graph taking voltage on y-axis and current on x-axis, when the voltage is low, the line is straight, just like Ohm's law. When the voltage is high, the current is high. When the voltage increases, current increases. Thereby, the filament gets heated, the resistance increases. When the resistance is increased, what happens current? What happens to the current? Current decreases. Actually, according to Ohm's law, voltage increases, current also increases. So you have to get a sharp line. But current decreasing, not going to this side, it's going this. A curve, we get some curve. Instead of straight line, we get a curve. So that is why the Ohm's law does not hold good for non-ohmic conductors or non-linear conductors. Now let us see the resistance. The resistance of the conductor is defined as simply the ratio of the potential difference across the conductor and the current through the conductor. Resistance is equals to V by I. The unit of the resistance is ohm or volt per ampere. The unit of resistance is ohm or volt per ampere. And the dimension formula is ML square T minus 3 A minus 2. Now you see how we can define ohm. When I is equal to 1 ampere, voltage equal to 1 volt, you will get The resistance is 1 ohm. So now, how can you define the 1 ohm? The resistance of the conductor is 1 ohm. Then, if a potential difference across the conductor, a 1 volt potential difference across the conductor causes 1 ampere current through the conductor. If voltage is potential difference is 1 volt and current is 1 volt, then only you can say the resistance of the conductor is 1. Next, the resistors depend upon some factors, physical factors, as well as it depends upon the length of the resistor, the length of the conductor, the area of the cross section of the conductor, as well as the material of the conductor or the nature of the conductor. Nature of the conductor means the resistance of the metal changes. When the metal changes, its resistance also changes. The resistance of the aluminium is different from the resistance of copper. And the resistance of copper is different from the resistance of the silver. And also, it depends upon, previously said, depends upon temperature, pressure, as well as the impurities. It depends upon temperature, pressure and the impurities. For example, the trivalent impurities of the pentavalent impurities are added, its resistance changes. Next, the resistance are of two types. One is fixed resistance or fixed resistor. So, its resistance remains constant. Some resistors are the variable resistor. Its resistance changes. Those resistors are not fixed. It changes from it. The resistance changes from, it's always changes. It does not a fixed value. It may change from 1 to 20, 20 to 30 and so on, 100,000, like that. So these are the, this is about the resistance and its units and types of resistors. So this is about the Ohm's law, its limitation, its limitations. Which limitations? Ohm's law and limitations, as well as the resistance, as well as its unit. So this is about this Ohm's law and this one. So are you understood?
Yes.
Are you understood this lesson?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next time we'll come with another topic and we can discuss clearly. So up to that, okay.
Thank you.
Okay.